So hi dosto, welcome to you all in my YouTube channel, and today I'm going to discuss about MD, or we can say like medicine, MBBS you can do or not after your bachelor degree in pharmacy, nursing and BPT. Maybe whatever you did your bachelor degree in health science, and now you are thinking that you can do in medicine, you can get admission, is not. So I will explain in this video what are the countries are offering such program, and what is the process there, how you can approach, and what are the exams requirement. Everything I'm going to cover in this video, because this video is important. I receive more than 100 message regarding this. After PharmD I can go for medicine. Many of people are arguing that the PharmD is equivalent to MBBS, many are saying is equivalent to MD and all these. I'm not going to discuss on all these. I mean the controversy. I'm going to just the, if you want to go for medicine, so you can go, I mean you can do, and this is one of the best course in the world, you know, in India mostly, you know, like IITs, engineering, and then we have to go for the MBBS. So these are the two courses, and other courses are not that much reputable and all these. So many people are think that we did this course after BPharm or PharmD, so we can go for medicine or not. So in this video I will cover all these. So first question, that there are many opportunities for pharmacists after they have done pharmacy. Means you did your bachelor degree in pharmacy, and you have lot of the opportunities in pharmacy, in industry, in hospitals, clinical research, pharmacovigilance, here and there you can work. Or even if you want to go for such some courses, for example, Master of Pharmacy you can do, and MS you can do, MPH you can do, Master of Public Health, MBA Healthcare, you know, and PhD, you can do lot of the courses. Then why you have to choose this the Doctor of Pharmacy, you know? And there's a degree named Doctor of Medicine that can be done after PharmD or BPharm. Here are some of the details I am going to discuss here, and so let's begin. So if you are new in my channel, please subscribe my channel, and here in this channel you can find more than 100 videos about regarding the job in other countries, for example like US, Canada or Australia, the UAE, UK, whatever the countries you are looking for job, or you're looking for the admission in any of the course, please explore my channel and go through there, and see if you have any question, just comment. Most of the time I reply to the comments, and yes, so we can go further. So why the question is that why pharmacists do MD? You know, pharmacy already is the good profession, but you know, there is a some politics and all these due to that in our own countries like India and Pakistan. Those countries not have a good reputation. Pharmacist just like a dispenser. Even in the India and Pakistan, this country, like more than 90% pharmacies are running without pharmacists. So there is no need pharmacist. You just any 10th pass person can open a pharmacy. There is doesn't matter who is your PM, who is your CM, you know, because I saw last lot of many years, and nothing is going to change in those countries, you know. So many people are think that the PharmD, I mean medicine, is a good career, and lot of the opportunities for doctor in India, and lot of the scarcity of doctor. There is no doctors, especially in the rural areas in India. And important that the pharmacist cannot prescribe, you know, pharmacist cannot prescribe, even the PharmD cannot prescribe a medicine. PharmD is just a pharmacist, not a doctor. You know, many people are asking me, this is they can prescribe, they can open their own clinic, so they cannot open on clinic as a doctor, you know. So you have to do MBBS or either MD, then you can go for you can open your own clinic. And pharmacist is not specialized at diagnosis. Pharmacist just specialize in the medicines, to the like preparation, to give some counseling to the pharmacist, all the patient care for pharmacists, but not very lack of the knowledge about the diagnosis. So for that, you must go for MBBS or MD. I mean, MD or MBBS. In India, MBBS is bachelor degree and MD is a master degree. But some countries, MD is like they consider as a master degree, but that is a minimum requirement to work as a doctor, you know, nowadays especially. And pharmacists are not allowed to do even minor surgeries. Pharmacists cannot do any surgery. Pharmacists cannot prescribe any drug. Even NMC 2019 also did not give any power to pharmacists. You know, even I argue a lot of time my videos and my own research papers I publish, but government was not think that's a birthful. But they give to the some of the like nursing, they give nursing can go for NMC and they can go further for MBBS as well. So if you are looking at I upload that video, that lateral entry, that nursing can go in lateral entry into the MBBS, you know, but dentists also they can go for the lateral entry, but the pharmacist cannot go at the moment, you know, and I'm not hopeful in future as well. And why not do MD after pharmacy? Earlier was, you know, and then here, you know, you will find many professionals that they will think, suggest you the not to go MD or after PharmD. You know, many people say that PharmD is a or a BPharm is a good degree. You can do a job or even you can do some business or something. Everyone have their own mind. If you want to go for this, then I'm suggesting this is a very good course. This is a golden chance. If you want, you can you can go. But the summary is here in the slide that if you did from outside country your this the MBBS or MD, then you have to give a MCI screening test in India or PMDC in Pakistan. They will test yearly twice or thrice exam, then you have to pass, then you can practice as a doctor, you know. And so some of the country like US, they are offering you can do in the US, you can do in Australia, you can do in Russia. So you know, all these we are going to discuss. So where to do, I mean, where you have to do your MD, you know. I mean, in Pakistan, PharmD is a minimum requirement as a pharmacist, that is a 5-year degree. But India have 4-year degree and 6-year degree. So all, so whatever you have BPharm or you are have PharmD, you know, both are eligible for MD, you know. Because MD requirement, they just say anyone have bachelor degree in health science, related to the health science. Those are studied like especially like biochemistry, microbiology, anatomy, physiology. So these are subjects you already are study in your bachelor degree, then you are eligible to go for this MD program, especially, you know. So there are many institutions are offering this degree. The cheapest is considering is Russia. If you want to go for the cheapest country, I mean the fee, then you have to go for Russia. And Russia have the fee very, very less. Is about Indian rupees, we can say is about 15 lakh to 12 lakh to 20 lakh. I saw the figure. So in the on an average 15 lakh is the fee all this program. But other countries also you can go for US and Australia also offering this degree. But US, first the condition in US after pharmacy, you have to be a registered pharmacist in the US. So in US only pharmacists they can register as pharmacist. Like earlier I already uploaded my two videos on the US. If you want to see the whole process to register the pharmacist, so please go to and watch that video. So in that mostly those have 5-year degree, that Indian Pakistani PharmD and Indian PharmD both are eligible to be a pharmacist in US, but the BPharm cannot be a pharmacist in US. So in Australia, then what is the Australia? So I am going to detail about in Australia only. I'm in Australia currently here, so I know all these the process here. So any bachelor degree in health science, you are pharmacy, you are nursing, you are, I mean any degree, optometry, you know, you can go for this program. So Yes, so all these even in Pakistan there are few universities are offering. If those are Pakistani student, they can go here. This is King Edward Medical University. Another one is the Aga Khan University. These two universities are offering to the MD program after the after the pharmacy. So you can go for there and you can get some admission on all these. And in Russia and US, you have to explore yourself. So I'm going to discuss just only in the Australia. So in Australia, the international applicant must fulfill three main requirements to be eligible for admission. First, your the degree, and you have very high GPA, is about 3.6 and above out of 4. If you are your percentage, and you can calculate what is you have the GPA. So first requirement, you have a bachelor degree in health science, any health science degree, you can be eligible. And number two, you have to clear a test that is called a GAMSAT and MCAT. What is this? This is a Graduate Australian Medical School Admission Test. This is a GAMSAT. Another one is the MCAT, Medical College Admission Test. These two tests, any of the tests you have to pass. And first you have your degree. The percentage may be 70 plus. If you have a bachelor degree, I think 65 plus. And then you have to pass this exam. And then third one is the interview. After third point, you have your sufficient marks in your bachelor degree and you already passed that GAMSAT and MCAT, and the third they will interview you through the Skype or maybe whatever. This is also depend on university to university. And number four, you need to be a English requirement, that is a IELTS. You have to give a 7 band in each. So these are the four requirements. After that, you are eligible to get admission in Australian university. And most important here, what is the scenario for doctor in Australia? Australian system is fully government funded, so you need to pay anything, and doctors are earning here a huge money, especially a lot of Indians doctors here. I'm going to make another video that the system, healthcare system, and the doctor's requirement. If you are MBBS from India and Pakistan, so you can watch that video. In this video, I'm just, if you have any health science degree and you want to pursue your MD degree in Australia, so you can pursue any of the university. If you want to see the what are the universities are offering, and maybe you are looking for the low fee university, so already I made 3 videos on this series, the top 10 universities, you can watch that. Another way, that top 10 universities in Australia, those are very cheapest fee. Another one is the top 10 universities in the regional areas, because all these are process are important, because you will get a PR based on your how many you have the points and all these. So you can watch those videos, and if you have any further questions, you can ask me, and please subscribe my channel, and thank you for watching this video.